In this video, we'll be talking about conditional permutations. Our first example is how many odd counting numbers can be formed from the digits 3, 4, and 5 if no repetition is permitted. Now for this problem, we have to recognize that our counting numbers, we can have one-digit counting numbers, two-digit counting numbers, three-digit counting numbers, and so forth. But since I'm only allowed three digits to work with, then I'll only be looking at one, two, and three-digit counting numbers. So to start, the number of numbers with one digit is only two. Since I'm only looking at odd one-digit numbers, then I can have a 3 or I can have a 5. So there's two of those. Then the numbers with two digits, I have to fill in this back space first because it has to be an odd two-digit counting number, and I have 3 and 5 to choose from. So there's two choices for this last spot. Once I've picked a number for that last spot, then I no longer have three digits to choose from. I only have two to choose from. So this time then I only have two to choose from for this spot, and the product here is 4 by the fundamental counting principle. And then numbers with three digits, again I need to fill in this last spot because it needs to be an odd number, and I only have two odd numbers to choose from. Once I fill in that spot, then I only have two numbers to choose from again for this spot. And once I fill in that spot, then there's only one digit left to choose from for this one. So the product here, fundamental counting principle, and I have 4. Then to find how many odd counting numbers can be formed, I add these up. I have 2 one-digit, 4 ways to pick two-digit counting numbers, and 4 ways to pick three-digit counting numbers. So the total, if we add those up, is 10 odd counting numbers can be formed. My next example, find the number of odd three-digit counting numbers that are less than 600. Now my first step would be to fill in to make sure it's an odd number. I have to have three digits this time, which means I have three spots to fill. And in order for it to be odd, this last digit needs to be filled in from one of these five digits in order for it to be odd. So I have five ways to choose that number for that position. Then in order for it to be less than 600, I have to fill in this front space next. In order for it to be less than 600, I have to have a digit that's below 6. If I put a 6 in here, then it'll be more than 600. So I can choose from the digits 5, 4, 3, 2, or 1. So I have 5 ways that I can fill in this number. Now notice it's not saying anything about repetition, so I am allowed to repeat digits. And then finally, for the middle spot, there's no restriction on the middle digit, So I can choose 0 through 9. And the fundamental counting principle says then that multiply those number of ways together. And I have 5 times 10 times 5, which is 250.